prefer to chat with your physician. Now, many people who have this condition prefer the term little person or person of short stature. Now, for some, dwarf is acceptable, but for most, midget is not. But hey, here's an idea that anybody can agree on. Why not simply call a person with dwarfism by their name? Now, I finally want to introduce you to my family friend, Annie. That's who she was originally. Question one. What is the most difficult thing about being a little person?
Facing different challenges throughout the day, whether it would be walking up to a building with steps, whether or not there's an elevator, whether or not I can reach anything I might need, getting on and off of a chair or a couch, or reaching something out of common.
Now, dwarfism is characterized by the short stature. Now, technically, this means an adult height of 4 feet and 10 inches or under, according to the group Little People of America. Now, second question. Now, did your parents know before you were born that you were going to be a little person?
No. My mom and dad, back then, they didn't have the technology that they do today. There wasn't a lot of testing.
Yeah, can I stop for a minute? Okay, now, I want to ask you guys, how old do you think Annie is? Okay, now, if you guessed 48, then you are correct. Now, question 5. Is there anyone else in your family that is a little person?
No. As far as we know, back in the generations, no. My mom has had relatives over from Ireland, and I've even asked them, and there is nobody that we know.
Now, there are 200 types of dwarfism, most of which are genetic. Now, the most common type, accounting for 70% of all cases, is called achondroplasia. What can you tell me about growing up as a little person? Now, did you get bullied? Or did you get treated as everybody else?
At the beginning, you know, when I was in kindergarten, I don't remember any teasing. But into grade school, early grade school, I got a lot of teasing. But at home, I was treated just like everybody else. I did the dishes, I helped with supper, set the table. But, you know, people can be mean, and they were.
Now, it is possible, though, for little people to have an average-sized child. Have you had any medical problems related?
Yes, I have. I've had a couple back surgeries due to a normal-sized spinal column. And because of the normal spinal column, it's put into a short body where I get some compression of the vertebrae together, causing some nerve damage. And because of the nerve damage, I'm walking with a cane or walking with my braces. So, yes, I've had surgeries because of being deaf.
Now, my final question. What helps you get around from day to day?
Well, let me show you.
Thank you.
Okay, we're now in my bedroom. I have a high bed. As you see, I need a stool to get into bed. When I'm putting on my makeup, I'm sitting on the floor facing the mirror because I cannot stand. In the bathroom, I have a stool to reach the sink. I use the sink vanity to get on the toilet. And then I have handrails for the bathtub for me to get in and out of. Okay, now we're in the kitchen. I have a small table, but that doesn't mean anything. It's just because I have a small kitchen. As you see over by the sink, I have stools to reach the sink. I also would use this to reach the stove. And now let me show you the van that I drive every day to work. just because I hate